So the snake trying to escape the pursuing stick with sudden curvings of thin long body. How beautiful and graceful are his shapes. He glides through the water away from the stroke. Promises once kept should be made. Is it okay? Is it okay? Yes, make it correct. Yes, promises once made must be kept. What did I say, Koyesh? Keep your word. Okay. The snake trying to escape the pursuing stick with sudden curvings of thin, long body. How beautiful and graceful are his shapes. He glides through the water away from the stroke. Oh, let him go over the water into the reeds to hide without hurt. Small and green, he is harmless, even to children. Along the sand, he lay until observed and chased away. And now he vanishes in the ripples among the green slim reeds. So the poet seems to be very fond of snake. The poet seems to be a snake lover. Instead of getting dreaded or scared of the snake, he is very, very fond of him. He's rather appreciating or praising his beauty. He's able to find beauty in his shape and curves. And his purpose is to tell. Write down names of those four boys. Not even four, only Jayant and Keshav. In this class, the most dash kinds of children are only two. The whole class is set only you two. Written? Afterwards, you take the numbers from me and call from reception. Their parents will come today before 2 o'clock. Why parents? Because once the parents must be told what their children are in the class, then we will take action. Okay, Keshav? Ab kyun nahi karenge aap? Okay, I'll see. So the snake is trying to escape the pursuing stick. So there are people, those who are very cold and cruel towards nature. And one such example of such cruelty is that the snake is being chased by somebody with a stick. And the snake is only trying to escape from that stick. It is trying to defend itself. With sudden curvings of thin, long body. So the snake is trying to slither away from the place where it is being attacked by the stick. And at this time, his curves and thin body is very graceful and beautiful. How beautiful and graceful are his shapes. So the action of slithering away from the place with his moves and curving action makes the things very prominent. It fascinates the poet. He glides through the water away from the stroke. So he glides. What is gliding? Gliding through the water. Yes. Skim. So it, you know, floats through the water. It is able to cross the waters. So his body is such, you know, adjusted in water also that it is able to get along waters well and is able to get to the safest corner. Oh, let him go over the water into the reeds to hide without hurt. So the poet doesn't want that the snake should be caught at any rate. So his only plea is to make the snake get escaped and and he just wants that the snake should only live his life the way it lives. So let him go unhurt, let him go escaped, and let him hide in the reeds of water without getting hurt. So let him go over the water into the reeds to hide without hurt. So don't hurt him. Don't catch him. Let him go and let him hide himself among the reeds. small and green, he is harmless even to children. So these small green colored snakes are always harmless. Okay, black colored snakes are poisonous. Okay, especially if the snakes are green colored, they are very, very harmless. Okay, so the poet says that this kind of snake is not even harmful for children. Then why to hit him? So small and green, he is harmless even to children. Along the sand, he lay until observed. So the sand gives him the camouflaging effect. So let him go and have fun in the sand also. It will keep on lying in the sand until it would be observed. So it doesn't even move unless you go near him. It doesn't even move. Then what's the fun of attacking it or hitting it? So the camouflaging effect of the skin against the sand make the sun hide itself in sand also. So along the sand he lay until observed and chased away. And now he vanishes in the ripples among the green slim reeds. And now he vanishes. So now finally it has gone away even from the sand. And it has gone into its hiding place somewhere among the reeds in the waters. Okay. So the process, the snake is trying to escape itself from being caught or hit by human hand. And eventually it goes to its hiding place, that is the reeds which are there in the waters. Got it? So in this process of the snake's trial to escape itself, the poet is able to present to us the beauty of the snake. Okay, when the snake was slithering and gliding through waters and all, the poet was able to make out like how beautiful the creation of God is. And we human beings are hardly able to appreciate that beauty. Rather, we are just there to harm it only. So that only shows a human being's cold or cruel attitude. Because all species on this earth, they only add to the ecological balance. Okay, so let's not break that balance. Okay, let us live and let others also live. Live and let live. Okay, if they don't kill us, then we also don't have the right to kill them. Okay, this was a simple poem with no complications, with no intricacies. Okay, now look at the questions. Yes, girls, not to look back. So what's the snake trying to escape from? When is your test today? Saturday. This poem will be the test. And what was the previous poem? That poem will also be the test. Saturday. Okay. Is it a harmful snake?
No.
What's the color?
Green.
So it's a green colored snake, and green colored snakes are hardly poisonous. The poet finds the snake beautiful, finds the words he uses to convey the beauty. Yes? Beautiful, graceful, and his shapes and sign of exclamation. Okay, curvings of thin, long body. These words are all the ones which depict the beauty of the snake. Yes, which homework is going on? Okay. Yes, children, you have to do these 5 questions on the fear notebooks of this chapter. Okay, and of the previous poem also, all the text questions must be done on fear. Anjay.